I'm Andy Olson, Ecozoi Ministries. Thanks for joining me for another edition of Lessons in Logic. And for this particular episode, I'm going to talk about false dichotomy, or sometimes called false dilemma. And the way this particular fallacy works is that it works on the assumption that when there's a question being discussed or debated, that there's only two possible outcomes. So think of it in terms of a test. A false dichotomy would be looking at things through the lens of a true-false question on a test, whereas in reality, it's not a true-false. It could be a multiple choice, it could be a fill-in-the-blank, it could be an essay question, it could be anything other than true or false. So the idea here is that there is more than two possible options. So we'll see this in, like, maybe in governmental systems. And really, with any of these examples, what we're looking at is extremes. A lot of times when you see a false dichotomy, it's looking at extremes, trying to show that one extreme or the other has to be the case. And in governmental systems, we see that as maybe authoritarianism, totalitarianism versus anarchy. And one is complete and total government control over every aspect of every person's life, versus pretty much no government at all in anarchy. Here in the United States, our political system, that's governmental system, our political system, we often think of our politics in terms that really are a false dichotomy when we look at Republican versus Democrat. This isn't so common in parliamentary systems overseas, but here in the United States, we've got two major political parties that win almost all elections, most elections, and that's kind of where this comes from. It's the fact that it's typically one of the two. So people will say, well, that must mean those are the only options, and really it's not. So anytime you see a third party candidate or person, somebody who's not a Republican or a Democrat on a ballot, and in most states they do allow other people to get on a ballot, then by insisting that it's Republican versus Democrat would be a false dichotomy. We also see this in theology. Pelagianism versus hyper-Calvinism would be an example with the question of salvation. Pelagius was a heretic that basically said that all people are born as a moral clean slate, and that we can work ourselves to moral perfectionism and salvation. And of course, that's heretical. And on the opposite side of the spectrum would be, for lack of a better term, hyper-Calvinism. You know, something where, say, that people have no moral responsibility whatsoever, that God is not only sovereign over everything, but to the point where we have no responsibility in our actions or decisions. Now, in reality, both Arminianism and traditional Calvinism are going to be more kind of on the middle of that spectrum between Pelagianism and hyper-Calvinism. And both, even though I'm not an Arminian, both Arminianism and Calvinism are going to be closer to the biblical view of salvation. And so the key here is, in all of these examples, is, as I mentioned, that we're looking at extremes. We see this an example from Scripture. John chapter 9, verses 2 and 3 says, "And his disciples asked him, 'Rabbi, who sinned, this man or his parents, that he would be born blind?' Jesus answered, 'It was neither that this man sinned nor his parents, but it was so that the works of God might be displayed in him.'" So the disciples were committing a false dichotomy fallacy by assuming that there were only two options that could have resulted in someone being blind. And Jesus demonstrates that, no, there was a third option. In fact, there were probably many options as to why this person would be born blind. But Jesus gives the right answer would be so that the works of God can be displayed in him. So the next edition of Lessons in Logic, we're going to talk about the middle ground fallacy. That would be the opposite of a false dichotomy. And I won't lay that out now, but I'm sure you can tell where we're going with it. And so we'll be back in about a week to talk about that middle ground fallacy. And so thanks for joining me for Lessons in Logic. Again, the address on the screen, you can check out The full seminar that we did on logic a few years ago. Also, if you're not familiar with it, there is, I'm sure you're probably either watching directly on YouTube or you're watching through an embedded YouTube link or whatnot. If you go to the YouTube page, you can check out this whole series is being added, each new episode is being added to a playlist, so you can actually auto play your way through the whole Lessons in Logic series as it goes on. So thanks for joining me, and Lord willing, we'll be back soon with that middle ground fallacy and another edition of Lessons in Logic.